All right, thank you so much, everyone. Thank you to those that have been subscribing my channel, and thanks to all the questions, contributions on YouTube. To those requests, I'm going to treat them one after the other. But for today, I want to quickly touch a request from a friend, and how to use multi-timbres on the Cubase, any Cubase, provided you have contact. Okay. And you can do that with hypersonic also. But I think with contact is more mature. The sample's great. Okay, you're a producer. Sometimes you find it difficult to add more MIDI instruments into your project because you experience audio dropout. There is a solution. Multi-timbres. You can load multiple instruments into one plugins, then connect, channel them into different tracks. It's that simple. And it will save you a lot of energy and a lot of dropouts. So if you are running a project of maybe 11 VST instruments loaded on with different samples with like purity, hypersonic, and different kind of, just imagine the weight to pull on the system. On top of that, you will also add some plugins to mix the voices and mix the instruments, and before you know it, you are experiencing audio dropouts that large. So there is a solution, and step number one, go over and load Kontakt. Why Kontakt? For me, this is the best we can use for this tutorial. You can also do that on hypersonic if you don't have Kontakt. Okay, I will go over and load all the instruments I want for this project. Okay, first of all, let me load the piano. I use these keys for the main piano, and it sounds great. Okay, this is the piano. Okay, piano is loaded. I don't need to open another Kontakt, same Kontakt. So the next thing I'm going to do is let me load maybe like a guitar. Can load as much as want, up to 16. Can load up to 16 of that. That's loaded. Then the bass, can load the bass, classic bass. That's 3. Okay, and let's look for synths, orchestra, or pad. If you don't have them here, not going to waste time on that. Just go over here and load any. Okay, this is strings. I'm going to load. Let me load this. I'm going to load this. Okay. Maybe let me load the last one. Organ. It's a general organ. Okay, let me see how many we have here. This 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we have 5 different samples loaded into one Kontakt body. So we'll close this. The next thing you do is you create the MIDI, create an empty MIDI tracks, matching the number of instruments you loaded on your Kontakt sample. So click add. All right, so let's test. This is your own. This is your bass. So you start, you name them. This is horn. Let's see what this is. It's a string. Solo string. Let's see what this is. This is your organ. Let's see what this is. This is your piano. In case you are confused, just come over here, because I think on the Cubase 11, it will just automatically help you to arrange them accordingly. But I think on 5, it will just stay on default. So what you do is come over here. Is the first there, so it's on 1. Then you can see this on 2, 3, 4, and 5. So we're going to take this off 6. So we have 5 different five different samples loaded here. Okay, let's create a short piece. Then I will tell you the last process, how to mix them. sorry, how to, if you miss that step, you miss everything. Then you won't be able to mix them separately because they're coming from one space. Okay, let us play something different here. I have five different instrument playing. They're not so perfect, but it's a good one. You come over to your mixer, and this is the step you don't want to mix. Of course, when you add your MIDI tracks, the default way they will come is like this: off. Your panning off. Apart from the stereo in, let me put this off. Apart from, you can see they are all coming out from this one sample because you loaded just one contact. So go over to your contacts. Go to your outputs, bring out the outputs for all of them. So you can see they are playing from one stereo. So all you need to do is just create up to five stereos here. You can link them later, delete existing. Okay, let's go. Okay. Then the next step we need to take is you start connecting them gradually. Do is go back to your outputs and make sure they are selected. So this is on one, leave it on one. That's piano. Go over here, output, leave this on two, which is three and four over there. Go back to bass, leave it on, go back to the stereo three. Because you created five, don't forget. Go over here. Put this on stereo 4. Come over here on stereo 5. So let's play. Of course, you can see. You already have the piano playing there, but if you come over here to your contact instrument, you can see they are all moving here. So this is the last step. Go over to your VST instrument and activate outputs. If you mix this step, you mix everything. You can just activate all of them, but there is no need. Just put on one after the other. That's it. You can see they are all playing. Okay, let's come over here. You can see they are all playing one after the other. Okay, let's solo them. This is your piano. This is your piano. This is your horns. You can choose whatever horns you want. Okay, and let's solo the other ones. This is your bass. So you cannot come over here. You can come over here, add your EQ. You can add any EQ you want. So, let's solo this one. This is your SAS instrument. And this will be your organ. I think there's a string somewhere. So this is it. Then the last step, you come over here and name them accordingly. So this is your horns. That is how you can do that up to 16 different instrument loaded on one sample. And let's check our audio performance. I'll see your average is still okay. And just in case you do that and you are still having a little, you know, poor sound and the rest, come over here, go to advanced. For other Cubase, they are different. No, so you come over here and click activate Steamband audio power scheme. Now that's if your system is strong anyway, click that and help. Another way to also reduce audio dropout is, please appreciate me by subscribing my channel on YouTube. More and more tutorials released during the week, and you will be the first to be notified so that every time I just upload a new stuff, you will get to know about it. Thank you so much. God bless you. See you next week, Friday.